Hello everybody, I am Raghavesh. In this video session, I am going to discuss about Proteus, a simulation environment. First of all, you can download this software from their homepage. You can see it's labcenter.com, and you can go to the downloads and you can get the demo version or evaluation version. Whereas there is a limitation on evaluation version. You can't print any schematics and you can't generate the bill of material and you can't save your work. That means you can just construct the circuit, you can simulate and check the results, whereas you can't save that work and you can't get back to that work again. And you can't simulate your own microcontroller based design. However, you can use this software for learning the basic digital electronic based simulations or analog circuit based simulations. This will be very handy software. So far, you might have used a couple of ECAD tools, or you may be looking for a better ECAD tools. In such case, I will recommend this Proteus environment, as it has a lot of features. We are going to discuss about one by one in this session, along with demonstration. This is actually a very simple ECAD tool in compared with other products. I don't want to name those things. And of course, it has a wide range of analog and digital components. What I mean here, like a wide range of transistors and things like that in terms of analog circuits design. And also digital circuit design, you may have TTL and CMOS ICs and the components, things like that. And also there are a lot of virtual components like push buttons, LEDs, relay, LDR. There are so many components are there, including latest integrated circuits. There are virtual instruments like oscilloscope, meters, and lot of debugging facilities also available in this one. If you look for PCB design, they have their own product which is called as a ARES. It is linked to your PCB design also. That means whatever circuit you draw, that can be easily converted as a PCB layout, and maybe from the layout you can go ahead with your processing your PCB using the manufacturing facilities. What are the circuit that can be simulated using the Proteus environment? Of course, it's a simple analog circuits and also simple digital circuits, and the mixed mode simulation. That means you can have both analog and digital as well. The microprocessor and microcontroller based circuits. We have a limited scope on microcontroller based design. Nowadays, most of us, we are using microcontroller based designs. And of course, we can have a memory interfacing. This memory is not limited to only RAM or ROM. Even we have a serial memories and advanced memory technologies also available in this software. And most of the circuit, we can do it in an interactive mode also, like which will show the direction of current flow and all. But the simulation speed is restricted over there. As like other Windows software, you have to just click on start or programs, look for Proteus, or you can type the keyword like ISIS professional. And once you type, you come up with this software. The newer version, you may need to go to, the design studio. From there, you have to go to ISIS. Okay. So once you click on ISIS, this window get open and you can see the standard Windows based menus like file. You can go for new design, you can open the existing design, or you can save the design, things like that, the basic options, and the printing. We may use this export option because once you finish up your circuit, you need to export to a bitmap or maybe a PDF file, maybe for your documentation purpose. And you can see some options like view. You can see there is a grid lines. If you want to remove that, or you want to enable that, there are a lot of options are there which you can try it out. These are some standard options. Okay. First thing, you have to have a clear schematics manually. You have to develop in a paper things like that which you are supposed to draw, and then you have to transform into this environment. Okay. So we go to File and Standard Windows menu. You can see like Export and all. And again, Zoom in, Zoom out option is possible. And copy and paste, of course, it's also available. Now, how to construct a simple circuit? I'm going to demonstrate now a simple battery and a LED. Okay, and just I'm going to show you that. Default, this mouse, sorry, the cursor has to be activated. If you go to component mode, it's fine, or cursor, it's okay, selection mode. You just click on letter P here, that means place devices or pick devices. You have to type the keywords here. Like I'm just typing now, resistor. You can see it's a generic symbol. That means you have to place the resistor and then you can, you know, rename or, you know, fix the values, whatever values you like. Okay. So once you double click, you can see that get added over here. And same way, I'm just going to add maybe a battery, let us say as a VDC. I mean, battery is the best keyword, I believe. Yeah, battery is there. You can see there's a DC voltage source. So just double click, it get added. I need to add a push button. So I just name it like push button. So again, there is a push button. I just get selected this one. And I need to have a resistor. Sorry, I have already the resistor. So I need to have a LED. So there are multiple color LEDs are available. So you just type LED and the color which you would like to have, a red. And you have to choose this animated. Okay, so this LED is going to illuminate. You are going to see that. Okay, so LED red. And once you're done with your component list, just say okay. And first try to place the component one by one. Battery. You can also use your scroll button to zoom in, zoom out. Okay. So I'm just going to select a resistor over here. And the LED. And the push button. Just place it. And try to wire off them. This means you go to a edge, you get a pencil sign. From there, click and go through the way how you want to route the wire. And once you get into the another component terminal, just one more click. A click here and click here. And just complete the diagram like this. Now you can see whenever I drag, it comes up, right? In case you want to have a bigger circle, okay, you want to have it like this, then wherever you want to have a second turn, you have to click once. From there you continue until you join to the next components terminal. Okay, we have a closed loop circuit, and you may be aware the LED voltage drop is somewhere around 1.8 volt, something like that, or let us say even 2 volt, whereas we have here now 12 volt battery. The remaining voltage must be dropped across the resistor. Okay, so I just use calculator. Okay, so assume that I want to limit the current flow in this one like 10 milliamps. I have 10 volt, that means 10 volt need to be dropped here, divided by 10 milli. That means I should have 1 kilo ohm resistance. Okay, so I'm just double clicking on this component. Instead of 10 kilo, I'm just changing as a 1 kilo. Okay, now you can save the design. I just go to File, Save As. And I made a folder here. I'm just trying to save my file here. And once you have done it, just click on play button here. Now the circuit is getting simulated. When you push the button, you can see the LED is getting on. Okay. Now if you want to see what is the current, like as per our design, we expect 10 milliamp current should flow through this LED, right? So you can also have the current probe. Yeah, you have to stop the simulation before that. So place the current probe here and just simulate, and you will see here the current. Okay, at present the switch is open, so there is no current flow, and when you press it, you can see it's about 10 milliamps. Okay, there is a difference in the calculation because the voltage drop we have taken as a, you know, 2 volt for the LED voltage drop, but you need to check like what is actual voltage drop. You can see the voltage drop is like 2.2 volt. So if you change this parameter as a 2, that means you can see that 10 milliampere current flows through this circuit. Okay, but in a real time you can't change the LED voltage drop. You have to change the resistance value. You can't change the, you know, voltage drop value of the particular LED, because during the manufacturing process the voltage drop across the LEDs are fixed. That means based on the color there will be different voltage drop across the each LED. This is a very simple circuit using Proteus. We will see in the next video how to make little more, you know, bigger circuit. Hope you enjoy this video. Thank you very much.